Hi, my name is Rosanne Parker. This is
Divine Davis.
And this is
Shaquille Moore.
And we were with the group of dress code. So our problem with dress code is it is entirely too strict.
The dress code is more so based towards females, and it does not give any freedom to students to wear what they want or to show their personality or be a teenager.
The rules they're giving us at Carver Military Academy does not correspond with all the rules in the student handbook. And I feel like when they don't give us enough out of uniform days, we don't have enough time or happiness to express ourselves.
So today we found many findings, which you will see in like 5 seconds, of different people's opinions of Carver's dress code, out of uniform, in uniform. Most of our findings basically say that in uniform, nobody agrees with how strict they are on it with their uniform, but out of uniform, there are more women or young ladies who felt like the dress code was too strict, and young men were just like, it is what it is, you know? Like, they didn't really care, which made us come to the conclusion that the dress code is more so for towards young ladies than towards young men.
Student dress code.
So we're doing a project on student dress code. What's your name?
My name is Abel Armando.
And I want to know how you feel about our dress code.
Okay, so for the school out of uniform dress code, I think the rules for out of uniform is not necessary, because the key word is out of uniform. But when we do out of uniform dress code, we still have a uniform requirement that we need to meet. Like, we can't wear ripped jeans, we can't wear shorts, we can't wear open-toed shoes. Now, with open-toed shoes, there's a difference, because with open-toed shoes, you could get injured. So I see why that one's not allowed. But for ripped jeans and, like, tank tops, it confuses me, because I look at it like, wow, somebody's gonna really look at a kneecap and be like, damn, that kneecap's hot. Or, like, somebody's gonna look at it like, oh my god, that shoulder's sexy. Like, I think it's stupid to have a dress code on an out of uniform day. If it's out of uniform, that means there shouldn't be no uniform.
Period.
So if they're not gonna create a dress code that's actually out of uniform, then they shouldn't even call it out of uniform day. They should call it dress down day, or change the label of it, because it's honestly confusing to some students, and it's really silly how they send people home when they don't meet an out of uniform requirement, but it's out of uniform.
I'm gonna touch upon what Abel said. When they said we have out of uniform, they still expect us to wear jeans. Sometimes when we want to wear joggers, they don't let us wear joggers. Mm-hmm. Like for example, when we had that Friday thingy, like, girl, who wants to wear jeans? Some people want to wear joggers. They feel more comfortable in it. And some administrators that work here, they wear ripped jeans, and they never say anything about it. Like, girl, you don't want us wearing ripped jeans, but you got people that take care of us. For example, let's say it was sophomore year, end of the school year.
Because it's like, it's jeans. Period!
Can't wear ripped jeans. Can we wear ripped jeans when we have something underneath? Or
even that
too. Like, girl, we're not showing anything besides the legging underneath.
Code is, I don't like it. Because it's like, for what? Like, we're teenagers. We want to wear what we want to wear. It gets me mad, because I want to wear what I want to wear without somebody telling me, like, you can't wear that. Mm-hmm. You know? So, yeah.
Thank you.
You make me un poco loco, un poquitito loco. The way you keep me guessing, I'm nodding and I'm guessing. How count it as a
because, like, once we found out, we had a meeting with the head man in charge, Major Rouse himself. Which you will see that tape in like 20 seconds. You will see the video of our meeting with Major Rouse. And we basically just asked him a bunch of questions on why certain things are the way they are.
So, first of all, I want you.
So, I have questions about the dress code of Carver Military Academy.
Okay.
So, our first question is, why did the uniform policy change from when students could have ripped jeans and stuff like that?
first of all, I want more opportunities for you guys really to be, not necessarily out of uniform, but you, that for you to express your own individuality. I do. But they've got to show that with respect and with dignity. I mean, so we can't have students with jeans that are torn up, where we see a lot of flesh and all of those things, because that's disruptive to the educational environment. It is. When you think about it downstairs, have you guys seen the jeans where we say, here's the appropriate jeans, here's the not appropriate jeans?
Yeah,
I don't know if you guys have seen that. Are any of those jeans ripped?
No.
Sure they are. Some of those jeans that we're saying appropriate are ripped. If you look downstairs, we changed that because many of the students said, look at my jeans. My jeans have a hole in it, but they're shredded where you can't see any skin. We changed that policy so that you can have ripped jeans, but there can't be any large holes in those jeans so that we can see flesh. So sometimes students don't realize that we're changing policy when we're changing. Go downstairs, look to see, are there any jeans that are authorized with holes in the jeans, and you'll find it is. And that was because of students asking for that, and we did that.
Okay, another question. Most sergeants say that it is inappropriate to have your ankles out.
That's policy.
Okay, so.
I don't know if that's policy. Well, I need to look at that. I don't know if that's policy. Really important. Have any of you looked at the Carver handbook and looked at the student policy around what students can and cannot do?
Yeah, school make up their own policy. On the student handbook, says schools make up their own.
No. I'm talking about, we have about 100-page handbook that's digital, that's online, that you guys have. I'm saying that what you need to do is challenge the policy if it's not in there. Like, wait a minute, it says that in our policy around the ankles? I haven't seen it. So I don't know, I don't think that's the case. I have read the policy and helped write the policy, and the policy is demerits, how you wear your uniform, how you wear your hair. I don't know if there's something around what your ankles are, okay?
So
I need to look at that.
Why are we, on Fridays how we have the classy, uniform? We want to be able to wear our own jackets with our Class C uniform. That's how it was at first, but then it got later on where we had to wear the Class B jacket with it. Why is that?
So even if it's just a black jacket, like, why can't it be our own?
That's a great question. So I think that first, just let's step back a step and say, when I got here as Commandant, even 5 years later, there was no Class C. We're offering another day for students to be out of uniform to show some resemblance of high school student in a high school, right? Now, the thing about the coat, we can potentially look at that. I mean, I'm not completely opposed to that. I mean, that's something that I need to talk to the JROTC team about. You're not in uniform. You're not. So that's something we could potentially look at.
Okay.
It's off the table.
Mm-hmm. Just code. So for prom, we have to have certain restrictions too, where you can barely show your shoulders or barely have your back out or anything like that. But it's prom, and that's something you can express yourselves. That I can see if you have like something like really, really out, like something actually showing. But
yes,
we get to express ourselves. Why can't we? Why do we have to have restrictions on prom day?
Okay. Well, Ms. Morris, another great question. You guys, okay, heavy hitters, man. I'm not kidding. It's a promise on a nightclub. 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 Number one, there's a difference. When you're 25, whatever, and you want to go to a nightclub, think about going to a nightclub and going to prom. I think those are two different things. In terms of, I went to this past prom, which was the most elegant prom. You were there.
Yeah.
That prom was next level. And you were there. Willis Tower, 67th floor, 76th floor. Most of the girls, if not all, looked great. I have seen some proms when I got here where they did not represent Carver well. It was a nightclub situation. And that's what we're not going to have. We're going to be dignified about some of the things that we do. But we need to make sure that we do them so that you don't feel so restricted. But we can't have where students are coming to prom honestly with their dress
up to here, like right below. We can't have those kind of things there. It sends a bad message to not just the students at the prom, but look at what that's saying to other people that's Carver watching it. So, no. I think that we're very flexible.
Okay, I have one more question for you.
Thank you.
We wear a lot of uniforms. So, like, on Mondays, we wear jogging suits with hoodies and these sweatpants. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, we wearing the pants, shirt, the undershirt. The necktie is optional. The baits, the long socks. On Wednesdays, we wearing a jacket on top of all that. But the heat in this school is out of control. So, we got on all this uniform, but it's hot in this school. So, how do you guys plan on fixing that?
Parker, no, and I'm not an excellent question, and I get on the engineers like pretty mean about that when teachers are texting me. I ask teachers, Miss Chloesi, Mr. Centeno, Miss Brooks, if it's hot in the classroom, text me, and I'm texting the engineer saying what's going on with the classroom. You're right. I'm not gonna make any excuses about that. I'm gonna say, we still have a lot of work to do with the heating and cooling in this building. The district put $30 million into our school. The rooftop units that are air conditioned is supposed to heat quadrants of the building. They're still off after 4 years. Johnson Controls, which I've talked to the vice president, all of that, they did not do an effective job with the heating and cooling in the building. So here's what I've done. 3 windowless air conditioners that we have downstairs that I'm willing to give the teachers where so you have the windowless air conditioner, you open up the window a little slightly, and the water drains out, and it cools the room until the room gets cooled by natural. I've asked Mr. Centeno if he wants one, Ms. Colesi if she wants one, and Ms. Brooks if she wants one. But it's no excuses. We're constantly working that. So, you know, but we did buy the windowless air conditioners.
So basically, we found out that a lot of things that sergeants say we can do when we enter the main entrance is not as true as, you know, they claim it to be. We also found out that we have access to our student guidebook, which tells us, well, not so far, explains to us what we can and can't wear, because there actually isn't no section at all in the student guidebook that explains what you can or can't wear out of uniform.
Period.
And so our action is to take that to Major Rouse and anybody else above him or with him and let them know that we feel as if we should have a section in the student code book that explains to us our guidelines of what we can and can wear in and out of uniform.
Period.
Once again, my name is Majene Parker. This is
Divine Davis.
This is
Shaquille Moore.
And over there is,
oh my God, Aliyah Irman.
And we are a part of One Goal Class of 2020. Oh, right.
Damn.
Hi, my name is YJ Parker. I am a part of the One Girl group that focuses on students out of uniform.
I forgot what we focused on.
Dress code.
Military schools have this uniform.
Ah, oh, stop messing me up.
Can you hear me up?
And okay, then there's gonna be a black screen right here that says, what do this button do?
Pause.
Why is not pausing?
No, it just takes a picture.
There's no pause button.
Yeah, that takes a picture.
I probably just took like 30 pictures, but we're gonna cut that out. Right here is gonna be a screen that says, share your findings.
And that's